I'm Chris Bollwage, Mayor of City of Elizabeth, and William Reyes, the Director of Policy and Planning, will be available after this interview to say anything in Spanish for your viewers to follow up regarding the incidents of yesterday. Yesterday, a officer in the City of Elizabeth, Mr. Rocco Malgiri, an officer for 19 years in our city, was indicted by the Union County Prosecutor's Office. The background of this situation is back in early February of this year, an anonymous complaint was received by a captain in the Elizabeth Police Department. That anonymous complaint was initiated with a civilian complaint reform against personnel. It's called a CAP, Civilian Complaint Against Personnel. The very next day, two police sergeants were sitting in a pizzeria having lunch. A woman walked in who is an advocate for undocumented folks in our city. That woman said to the two police sergeants that, what do I do if a police officer is shaking down undocumented people in our city? The two sergeants then filed another complaint against personnel form in the City of Elizabeth and sent it to Internal Affairs. The Internal Affairs Division then did an investigation. During that investigation, they found a pattern of abuse by this one officer. This officer was meeting with people. It is alleged that he was meeting with people and pulling people over, asking them for papers if they belonged in this country legally, and then asking them if they did not want to get reported, that they would have to then give him some type of financial remuneration in order to not get reported. That officer did this for a period of time. After the pattern of abuse was documented, we then contacted the Union County Prosecutor's Office almost immediately, told them about the problem. A joint investigation between the Union County Prosecutor's Office and the City of Elizabeth commenced, our detectives and their detectives. And then after that, in May of this year, the police officer was arrested and he was then suspended without pay from the City of Elizabeth since May. The indictment yesterday is a culmination of the work of the Union County Prosecutor's Office and the Elizabeth Police Department in the arrest that was facilitated back in May. The officer is suspended without pay pending the settlement or the ending of the criminal investigation. So that suspension will continue without pay until this criminal investigation or the criminal trial is resolved. We're a town of 125,000 people. We have a lot of Hispanic people in our city. It's growing according to the 2010 census. This shows the system works, though, because I have met on numerous occasions with the day laborers of our city. We have neighborhood meetings throughout our city. And one of the things I consistently stress is that if there is a problem with a police officer, that someone needs to call us and tell us so it can be properly investigated. And for undocumented people in our city to step forward and say that there was a problem with the police officer, and then the investigation ensued, and the results of that investigation should give a solid commitment to the people of our community, whether they're documented or undocumented, that they have access to justice. But we have 320 officers. This is one officer. The investigation happened and we looked at other avenues. This is clearly one officer that acted this way. There is no evidence of any other police officers behaving in this fashion or attempting to do this. There are 58 counts against this officer. So there's an awful lot of people who came forward during this investigation. I don't have the exact number that's part of the overall investigation, but there's way more than one victim that came forward. If there are anybody else out there who believes this happened to him by this officer, or anybody else for that matter, but we didn't find anybody else, but if there's anybody out there who believes this happened to the officer, they need to call the police department at 908-558-2020 and ask for the police director, and it will be followed up. You know, it's sad that one police officer has chosen to do this, or at least be alleged to do this until the trial, but there's an awful lot of evidence that points in his direction. And it's really sad that one police officer has chosen to do this and possibly tarnish the reputation of the other fine working officers of the Elizabeth Police Department. But this officer was suspended without pay immediately, so it does not reflect on the other officers of our city. But just the contrary, because I think this shows the system worked. It showed that when you have over 10 or 15 people actually volunteer, many who are not documented citizens of our country, they trusted the police department on this issue. They came forward during the investigation. They put their names forward to make sure that justice is served. I think the message should go out to the community, and especially the Hispanic community, that the Elizabeth Police are serious about working with the members of our city, no matter what their background, in making sure there are no violations or civil rights violations to documented or undocumented people, especially of Hispanic origin.